Well, I've learned two lessons. One, I learned as soon as I walked into the room where the prisoners were the very first time. The second is sort of unfolded over time. So the first lesson I learned straight away when I walked into a room, and I walked into a room, there was about 15 or 20, mostly incidentally, there's mostly guys who got into prison and then subsequently found an interest in Buddhism. You also get some Asian people who are already Buddhist who find their way into prison, but mostly it's the other way around. So I knew that I was walking into a room, most of whom had been convicted of murder or rape or very, very serious violence. And actually, what I saw was not a room of monsters. You sort of expect that. They were a room of ordinary men. The sort of people, actually, that I could imagine outside of prison having as friends. And, they acted in very friendly and reasonable ways. They'd help with the tea. They'd be very pleasant. They'd make a conversation. And they were human beings. These are human beings. How long does it take to murder someone? They've been a murderer for 15 minutes in their life. But that's what they're defined as. That's not to belittle, incidentally, what they've done. But they are human beings. So somehow that was a sort of insight for me, I suppose, that actually what we think of as a sort of normal kind of human consciousness can sit alongside the kind of consciousness that's capable of those sort of acts. As human beings, it's mysterious, we're able to hold both of those at once. The second lesson that I've learned that's unfolded over a longer period of time is that karma is real. It's real, it's dull, it's ordinary. I've seen it there in the restless serial killer pacing up and down the corridor in the hospital wing of the prison. In the tortured, hellish face of the man who'd been a gangland hatchet man, hatchet crime, literally in his case. In the repeated bloody suicide attempts of a man who'd committed a drug-induced murder that he couldn't even remember. In the repeated self-harm of a young man guilty of a very violent offence, self-harm almost to the point of amputation. The pathetic, dead-eyed face of the notorious child murderer. And also in the cocky bravado of a young rapist who gets on with the other prisoners through the day but cries for his mother at night. All of this is karma at work, extreme karma at work, even if they don't get caught, even if they're not in prison. No one gets away with anything, and that's true. Journalists and crime writers take note. In a way, there's no glamour of evil here. There's nothing kind of special. Just sad messes of human life. Dull, day-to-day pain. And that's their predicament. If you've done something that serious, you put yourself in a predicament where you've got a stark choice, where you face two choices. One is the incredible challenge of facing up to remorse, facing up to what you've done, learning the daily reality of living with it, and somehow among that, beginning to lead a positive life, allowing it to change you. Or the worst hell of cutting yourself off from your own humanity, from any real abiding happiness, contentment, meaning, or softness. So that's what's really there, I think, if we really look. course, most of us don't see that because prisoners are put away. You know, I haven't met someone that extreme before I went into prison. The implications of the criminal justice system, very briefly, difficult to say. I don't have a well worked out programme. I don't think it would involve imprisoning people for punishment. I don't think even for deterrence, perhaps for public protection and no other reason. Much more therapy is needed. The amount of therapy in prisons is pitifully low. Scratch almost every prisoner and you find childhood trauma, childhood abuse, some kind of trauma. Nobody's listening. Also more therapy, more listening to victims. And yes, restorative justice, much more. Really, what other kind of justice is there? And I think in society we need to sort of build a culture where the reality of that kind of karma is understood, and also where the potential for human growth and development is understood. I think then while they're not understood, you'll still have the Daily Mail calling for retribution. So I did just want to say, I meant to say this at the beginning, that I'm here as an individual who the views that I've expressed and the any mistakes on my own. I'm not representing Anguli Mala prison chaplaincy. I just wanted to make that clear. These aren't their views, these are my own. So yes.